Do you guys want to know how we do so many giveaways and top-ups in Genshin without burning through our wallets? Well, here's the secret. There's this website called LootBarGG, where you can save up to 20% compared to in-game purchases. Since LootBar uses the official partnership route, you can enjoy all the official hoyoverse recharge events, meaning you can get twice the amount of Genesis crystals if you have the bonus. This is how I purchased 6,560 Genesis crystals for only $47. All I did was provide my UID and make the payment, and 1 to 2 minutes later, I received the crystals on my account. No hassle. It's completely safe and secure. If you don't believe me, LootBar has thousands of good reviews on their website. Take a look. Even big shots like Dukaja, Teyvat Times, and Jello Impact approve of LootBar, so head over to the link in the description and start saving money. New users get 5% off their first purchase. Hello, everyone. We've got some intriguing updates about Columbina's playstyle and details. This information comes from White, who recently shared insights about the connection between Xbalanque and the Pyro Archon. Columbina, also known as Damselette, is the third of the 11 Fatui Harbingers. According to White, she will be a 5-star cryo character and is expected to be a main DPS. While her weapon type hasn't been officially confirmed, older leaks from Black Rose suggest her weapon resembles a machete, hinting that she might be a sword user. The idea of Columbina wielding a machete might seem unusual, but considering the unique weapon designs we've seen, like Navia's, it's possible. However, remember that this information is several months old and could change. There has been speculation about Columbina's vision, with theories suggesting she could be Creo, Pyro, or even Animo. While the source didn't mention her delusion, her design suggests she might have a Pyro delusion. Some fans believed Columbina could be an Animo character due to the Sealy theory, but Team Mew recently clarified that Columbina is not a Sealy. Instead, she belongs to a blessed race with direct ties to the gods of Natlan. This term suggests she is similar to characters like Yaimiko or the Aranara, likely created by a previous Pyro Archon. Columbina is a mysterious character. Despite her seemingly indifferent demeanor, she is extremely dangerous, as warned by Tartaglia and Wanderer. Conversely, Arlecchino finds her unpredictability intriguing. It's unclear if Columbina will be an ally or not, but as a playable character, she must have some redeeming qualities. All playable Fatui Harbingers so far have been main DPS characters, and Columbina appears to follow this trend. Personally, I'm very excited about her potential. What do you think? Let us know in the comments down and below, and don't forget to check the previous video out for a welcome giveaway. Before we continue, make sure to check out our Discord server to take part in giveaways, participate in challenge events like this one, get instant leaks and updates, and hang out with other Genshin players, including me. Link is in the description. Thanks for watching and subscribe, or you'll lose your 50-50 to Chi-Chi.